गुड मॉर्निंग वन एंड ऑल. माई नेम इज़ रेशमा लखानी. आई एम फ्रॉम सीताराम नारंगजी पटेल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी उमराख. आई वेलकम यू ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ गुजरात टेक्नोलॉजिकल यूनिवर्सिटी. टुडे आई एम हियर टू डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग फाइल मैनेजमेंट इन सी एज पार्ट ऑफ सिलेबस फ्रॉम कंप्यूटर प्रोग्रामिंग एंड यूटिलाइजेशन. लेट अस बिगिन विद आवर प्रेजेंटेशन. आई विल बी कवरिंग द फॉलोइंग टॉपिक्स विच आर पार्ट ऑफ आवर सिलेबस. Up till now, as you know, we have been working with console-oriented input-output function. We all have used scanf and printf functions which allow us to write something on the terminal that is standard output screen and to take input from standard input device that is keyboard. आप सब जानते हैं कि scanf और printf functions हम input लेने के लिए और display करने के लिए use करते थे. What was the problem in that we were not able to store the data that we inputted, and if large volume of data was needed to be input, it was cumbersome and time consuming. So C has a huge standard input output library, and it also supports something called file. What is a file now? File is a group of related data that can be stored on disk. For using the concept of file, C supports in standard input output library, C supports some functions which help us to do following operations on file. First, naming a file, opening a file, reading, writing data to and from the file, closing a file. Whenever you need to create a program in C for making your file, first we need to give file name, we need to specify the data structure, we also need to specify the purpose of opening the file. File name consists of string of characters, data structure that we need for storage of our data as a file on the secondary disk is file, it is one of the defined data type in standard IO library. The purpose for which we want to open our file, that is specified as mode. We can open the file for reading purpose, that means the file is already existing and I want to open that file for reading the data from that file. I can also open my file for writing purpose, that means whatever the user gives through the program has to be returned into the file. And I can also open my file for appending purpose, that means already existing file has some content in it and more contents are needed to be added. How to use file in C program? We need to first specify the pointer fp type file. File is a data structure, as I told you, and in the next line you can see fp is equal to f open file name and mode. F open is a function which helps us to open the file in our program. FP is a pointer which will store all the information related to the file name that we are giving. The mode will help us to tell the program in which mode I want to open my file, that is read, write or append. Let us see further. File name, one example as shown in the slide, input.txt. The file name is a group of characters. It can have two parts, the primary name with a period, and you can have extension. This is optional. Mode of opening your file, that means the purpose for which I want to open my file. R is a mode for opening my file in reading mode. W is the mode that I will specify for writing mode, and A for opening my file in append mode. This mode has to be specified in double quotation, as you can see over here. And file name also need to be specified in double quotation. This is one example where I have made two pointers p1 and p2 which are of type file. P1 is equal to f open data.txt r, where I am specifying that I want to open a file called data.txt in reading mode. As you can see, please note the syntax of this. Try to remember the general syntax, that is f open in double quotation, I have to specify file name and comma, I have to specify in double quotation the mode. So if I want to open any file called data.txt in read mode, the first p1 is equal to fopen data.txt r is the syntax that I will specify. Now I also wish to open another file, so I have another file pointer, that is p2 is equal to fopen result.txt, and the mode I am using is w. In first case, the file will be open in read mode. In second case, the file will be open in write mode. Now, we have to understand one thing regarding the mode. If I am opening any file which does not exist in read mode, then it will show an error. Fopen will return a null pointer, so I have to check p1 for condition null. Why? Because if the file does not exist, how can a program read from that file? If file is existing, it will be open and all the related information will be available through p1. So I can use p1 in my program for further working with my file. Now, second case, W mode. When I open any file in W mode, if that file is not existing in your secondary disk, it will be created. If it is existing, the data will be deleted and it will be available as a new file to us. If I open any file in append mode, the data will be retained in that file and we can add new data into that file. So we have to be very clear when we are using fopen function for working with file concepts. Once you have worked with your file, at the end of your program or whenever your file pointer is needed to be released, we should close that file. Fclose f file pointer. For example, in previous example, I had taken p1 as my file pointer. So if I want to release p1 from the file data.txt, I must close it in this way, fclose p1. This will release your p1 pointer with data.txt file. So I can use it again for next file operation. We must remember one thing, that after all your file operations are over, try to close that file, otherwise at the end of your program it will be closed. Now let us see how we can interact with the files that we want to create or read from our disk. There are two character oriented functions. First function is known as getc and second one is known as putc. I have placed one example over here. C is equal to getc in the bracket, that is parenthesis, I have file pointer fp. This is a pointer which was declared previously, which has to be declared previously. It has to be associated with any file. And by using getc, we are reading one character at a time and we are storing it to variable called c. It is same as get character function or get ch function of console oriented input output. Once again, let me repeat how to use getc. There is a function called getc. The parameter that I have to pass to getc is a file pointer. This file pointer needs to be pre-declared before using it. The pre-declared means it has to be associated with some file before being open. For example, here p1 is my pointer. When I write here p1, then it is accessing the file which has been linked through p1. Now it will read one character, and hence getc prototype says that whatever value is read, I need to store in some variable. So I will store it in c variable. I hope you got this point. Next function is putc function. First function was allowing us to read from the file. The second function allows us to write to the file. That is, if I want to write any value which is stored in variable c to the file associated with fp, I will use putc function. Once again, putc function helps us to write a character into the file which is passed as a parameter in the form of file pointer. In our case, the variable c value will be placed into the file associated with fp pointer. Previous functions allowed us to work with single characters. If I want to store any integer value into my file, or I want to read some integer value from the file, I need to have one more function, that is getW. Again, the syntax is similar. GetW, I have to pass the file pointer so that I can tell which file I have to access. When I use getW, it helps me to read one integer value from the file associated with this file pointer. Again, this function returns you one integer value, so I need to store it in a variable of type integer. This is the name of the variable, integer equal to getWFP. If my file FP is having one integer value, say 5, so integer variable is going to get value equal to 5. Integer equal to 5 will be the value after this line is executed. Similar to this, we have one more function called putW, which allows us to write one integer value to the file. Integer, this is the variable integer in which I am having one integer value. This value will be returned to the file associated with FP. I need to use putW function. These functions handle integer values. If I want to read or write more than single values, or at a time more than one values, there are two more functions. One function is to write into the file and one function is to read from the file. If I want to write something to the file, I can use fprintf function. I have to pass one parameter, that is file pointer. I have to specify the control string and I have to give the argument list. Let me explain it with simple example. Fprintf, if my file f star fp, fp is equal to fopen data dot txt. I am opening it in write mode. Now, if I want to store, for example, one integer value, one string value, and one floating point value. But before giving this control string, I have to specify here my file pointer. And here I have to specify argument list. For example, I am giving direct values, then I can write this way. This is very important thing. If I don't specify here, then where it will write? So, if I want to write something to the file, I have to specify the pointer. And before using this pointer, these two things has to be done. If I have not done this, then how it will identify which file it has to write? Again, if I don't want to write to the file, but I want to write it to the output screen, same as printf, I can also use fprintf function, and instead of writing any fp pointer, I can directly write stdout and other things same. This will help me to write whatever arguments I am giving here to the standard output, that is our screen. Now here, this portion, this can be given as different variable list. For example, a comma str comma f. I can give direct value also, I can give as a variable, and appropriate values will be replaced at this control string points. This is a function which helps me to write group of values at a time to my file or to the standard output, whatever syntax you have used accordingly. I hope this is clear. Let me go further. Fscanf. Now, if I want to read any value from my file or from the standard input, then I can use fscanf function. Now, if I am willing to read from any file, this FP must be associated previously with any file. Control string specifies which format I have to read my values. You can compare this function with your scanf function that you know. In scanf, we specify control string, which tells me what type of values are going to be read. And here we specify the list of argument. Whatever value that has been read will be stored in appropriate argument variables that we specify over here. Let me give an example. F scanf. If I am reading it from one file, I will write this way: percentage D, percentage S, percentage F, comma. My first value is integer value. If I want to store in any variable, call A. So ampersand A, as you have been using in scanf. Please don't forget to specify ampersand. Otherwise, the value will not be correctly accepted. Then, for string, we just specify the name of the character array. For example, it is str. And for float values, I can specify another variable name. These are the variable list that I am providing for reading appropriate type of value from the file and storing it to these variables, to the locations which are denoted by these variables, right? Again, if FP, instead of FP, I am writing std in, then what happens? It works like your previously known scanf function. It will accept value from the keyboard, standard input. I hope these two functions are clear. Let us see further. As I told you, there may be some error conditions while accessing your file operation functions. If I am opening a file which does not exist, or while reading the file there is some error. For example, you are reading beyond the available characters or numbers from your file. You have encountered end of the file. In that situation, some error conditions has to be noted. There are two functions which allow